Hey guys, we are back. I am Sobash, and yeah, it's been about a week and a half, so how's everybody doing? Paladin Strike, let's have a little conversation about this. So, in the past week, I've obviously haven't been around making content. I was sick. I'm sorry, I do apologize, but at the end of those last videos I did, I could almost not talk towards the end of them. I don't know if you could tell, but I'm finally back. We're able to do content again. I have still been logging in a little bit, doing some stuff, but we've got a lot of stuff coming up, and that's what I kind of want to talk about, is the upcoming stuff, kind of get you back into the mix of what's going on and kind of give you some insight from me on some things about the game as well. So let's start out to begin with about a new series that we're going to start doing, which is called Funny Moments. This was introduced to me by Hyrus Scott. He sent me a clip of one and I'll show it to you right here.
Behold the Dragon's Fury!
Let's die! Holy shit! We'll always love you! I can't believe you did this to me! God damn it! How could you do this to me?
Now, I want to start doing these because these are actually hilarious. So if you get clips, something like this, a funny moment, lucky moment, anything that's hilarious or crazy, make sure you can send it in. I'm going to show you the way. Also, I've been listening to your guys' feedback on the Best Play series that I've been doing, and I'm going to do some changes on that also. So be prepared. I think later today I'm probably going to drop a video and show you guys how to record this stuff at a higher quality. I have seen some of your submissions and some of them have a lot of tearing and they don't look very well, so we're going to try and show you guys the best way to record this stuff and get these clips sent in. So look forward for that later on today. But the feedback on the videos, guys, thanks. I like the actual conversations that you guys and the input that you'll leave on it, because starting out on them, you know, it's kind of just my ideas of how I want it to look. You know, I'm an editor, so I'll probably over edit it, and now I'm gonna have to step it back, and that's what I'm gonna do, is make it a little bit easier on you guys' eyes when you're watching it. So a lot of the flickering and the stuff like that's gonna be cut down, so look forward to those in the next probably couple days. If we can get some clips in, we're gonna need quite a few more submissions. I'll leave the information again below for the in the description about how to send these clips in. But also on top of that, let's talk about feedback real quick. So seen a post the other day on Twitter, and it was about how people are sending feedback in to Hi-Rez, and this little clip right here is just mind-boggling why somebody would even spend the time to type something like this out and send it into a company. For one, it leaves no insight. You give them no information on what happened. You're just basically wasting everybody's time. Now, leaving feedback, I did this myself after the first day after Shaolin came out. Now, I haven't gave you too much information about Shaolin as far as what I think about him. I just did the skills overview and that's it. That was before I'd played him at all in a match, and I wasn't too surprised with anything he's got. He's not very, very strong at all. He's probably one of the lower grade champions right now. I don't know if it's because of the runes or what, but I even runed him out some and he still didn't perform very well. So leaving feedback, it's a lot easier when you do something like this. Give them a format, give them some insight of what you were doing. If you clip it, show them a little short video of it. This is how, if you leave feedback, they're actually going to warrant it. They're going to actually be thankful for this, because now they have a way to see what happened and you're giving them information about what was going on. And instead of just being belligerent and cussing them out constantly for no reason, give them some insight on what they can fix. If they could reproduce it, they could fix it. So if they could see that, it's going to help them out a lot. This is just unwarranted, guys. Please don't do something like this. I know I have my frustrations and difficult times and playing different parts of this game because of certain things, but don't take it to this point. There's no point in it. Give them some constructive feedback. And like, for instance, myself, I don't like the rank system, but I don't put it out there like I hate it, because it's something that can change. For instance, give them feedback on it. Like, the way the rank system to me right now currently is that anybody that can play the game for a set amount of hours every week, you can rank up. That's it. The rank system, it doesn't show actual skill to me. And it can be changed. I mean, the point system, it works, but give something else to it. Say, for instance, you add in the tiers to the rank. So 1, 2, 3, 4s, give them some incentive to actually climb those tiers. The 1 week thing's cool for like rewards, and make it like a reward based system for every week, but let people grind out and try to rank up. So turn those numbers into, say, like every 100 or 150 points that you get like a star. It takes 4 or 5 stars to go up. I mean, that model is very similar to what Paladins is, but give people incentive to actually want to play to rank that up, instead of just mindlessly grinding to hope to stay in a top, you know, 5% to be promoted for that week. That's just my opinion, but I mean, that's how you need to leave feedback for this. I mean, I didn't go out of my way to belittle them on the how the rank system doesn't show skill or anything like that. Give them actual feedback, something that they can say, maybe if we do change this, maybe if we can get something like this done, they will like it better. But it's not going to happen overnight, people, either. So if you leave feedback, don't expect it to change the next day. It's going to take weeks, possibly months, for some of this stuff to happen, because it's a process. I mean, and I myself, I currently don't know exactly what that process is, but if it could be fixed later on down the road, let it be. But let the stuff that needs to be fixed first, let them handle that, like server issues and things like that. I haven't played a whole lot. I've still seen people say that they have had some server issues, ping issues, connections, disconnecting and things like that. It's gonna happen. It's still a new game. Yes, it's been in testing for like 8 months and in development, but the game hasn't been at a scale like this for what, a couple weeks now. They're gonna have to work out the bugs, just like any other game nowadays. It's a developmental process. You don't just go to a store anymore and buy a game, it's complete and it's perfect. That's not how gaming works anymore. It's evolved. And the way you have to give people feedback needs to evolve as well. You can't just cuss people out and to expect them to listen to you. That's basically what it's going to boil down to is, you know, give them proper feedback and wait for the results. And you'll more than likely see that information in those results. As you see, they do dev feedback. They do these every couple weeks. They post it on Twitter, ask your questions, and they literally will answer your questions about something you have on the game. Hardly any developers do something like this, and for the chance for you to interact with the company that is making this game, that's pretty huge in itself. So don't belittle the chance to have that opportunity. I mean, they post these on their channel, they don't get very many views, so people obviously aren't interacting and are concerned with certain parts of this, because either that or they can't find it. So go watch the dev stuff. I'll leave the Paladin Strike link in the description below as well. Go check out all the videos, they talk about this stuff. So if you have any questions, there's plenty of outlets to leave them, plenty of outlets to leave feedback, but just try to keep stuff positive. I don't want to see this game turn into just a toxic pool of just idiots that don't know how to communicate. But yeah, I just kind of don't want to see the community go down that hole, and it's something that I don't think anybody wants to see in any game that they play, because it just doesn't make for an overall good experience for anybody when it comes down to that. But yeah, guys, definitely expect some more content later today. I know Deathmatch came out, so we're gonna play some of that. Gotta get some more Realm Royale in, of course. I think they've done quite a few updates since I last played it. Some Paladins, of course, in there somewhere. And may even do some other stuff like Fortnite. Just depends on what you guys want to see. That I know that's coming to Android here pretty soon as well. So I don't know. It's going to be a lot of different content coming out. I'm kind of excited to get back into things. I'm really happy to be able to talk again. So Look forward to some more videos coming soon, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. We're going to wrap it up right here. Like, if you have any questions about anything I talked about, feel free to leave them down in the comment section down below. If you're new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn your notifications on, and leave a like on this video, as it does help us out a lot. But with that being said, folks, thank you again so much for watching. As always, like, comment, and subscribe. I am Soul Bash. You guys have a nice day.